Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. My name is Ashok, faculty for Reasoning as well as Mechanical Engineering. As a part of our short videos, in this video we are going to discuss a numerical or a reasoning problem. Do subscribe to our channel because you are going to get notifications of these short videos of various modules. You can see reasoning, you can see aptitude, English, general studies, science and engineering concepts. So for those who are preparing relevant examination, so do subscribe because you will be getting the notifications of our short videos. Let us see what we have in our in this video. So friends, we have another problem from this RBI assistant prelims of 2012, that is in this topic of inequalities from reasoning ability. So we have seen other problems also. Try to check other short videos also. We have been solving individual problems in individual videos so that it will be very much convenient for you, as we described already. So let us see what you have to do in this problem. The directions, basically we all know that some statements and conclusions are given. So whether we need to check whether those conclusions are following the given statement or not. So for that, appropriate option must be chosen here. So out of these five options, we know if generally two conclusions are given, one conclusion follows, so the option must be given. If both the conclusions are given, I mean both the conclusions are following the given statement, how the answer must be given. And one important case in this, either or case. So that is also has to be checked whenever we get appropriate question. We need to we try to understand it better. Anyway, you can understand that concept through our recorded session of live. You can find in our playlist. So go through our videos. Don't forget to subscribe because you will be getting the notifications of all these all such videos which will be useful in your preparation. So let us see ahead what exactly we have. As we can see in other videos, we have already covered two problems from this 2012 paper. This is third question. Let us try to understand this and try to choose an appropriate option here. So let us see. As we can see, first thing we need to do is check whether the statements are given in a single line or a group. So we need to appropriately make it into a single line is our aim. But so if doesn't happen, rearrange them in such a way that some path can be established between the elements which are used in this conclusion. Okay, so the relationship has to be made in this conclusion. So between those elements, we have to make some path. For that, rearrange these statements. So now that you can clearly observe here, I am rewriting those statements here. A is B, A is equal to B, is less than or equal to C is one statement. Another one is A is greater than R. So this can be easily merged here. Okay, we can put that into single line. So A is greater than R, obviously we can also read it as R is less than A. So now that we can see a common element, that is A, is at one end. Okay, so if at all common end, common element is at one end, we can easily merge those statements. So how do you put this here? So obviously take this here. If I put it here, so is that making any difference here? So obviously it is making some convenient part here only. We could make these statements together as a single statement now. So once you made this, it is very easy for us to understand this conclusions, whether they are following this statement or not. Let us see the first conclusion here. What is the first conclusion given here? B greater than R. So whether this happens or not, we'll check. Where are these elements? First we need to identify in this statement those elements here. B is here, R is here. Okay, so we have to identify the relation between them through the symbols between them. So let us identify what are the symbols between B and R. So less than is one symbol, equal to is one symbol. Obviously relationship can be easily established, but we need to check which one is to be prioritized, which symbol has to be prioritized. And the basics we know, and basics we understood through in previous videos anyway. So just watch that live session recorded, in that we cleared these concepts. And if at all you need some more clarification about the concept, just comment in our comment box so that we will make separate video to clear those concepts. So in this two symbols, we know how to prioritize. Obviously, the priority must be given to this less than. So based on this, what should be the relation here between R and B? R must be less than B. R must be less than B. So it is, in fact, obvious here that the other way, if we want to read this statement, I mean conclusion, R less than B, we can also read it as B greater than R. So if B is greater than R, obviously it is matching with our conclusion. Our conclusion one is true, isn't it? Then we will try to check this. So second conclusion is given as R is less than C. So which is true or not, we'll try to check. So first identify these elements in this statement. So what are they? Where is R? R is here, C is here, isn't it? So between these two, so let me write like this. So what are the symbols we need to identify? What are the symbols here? Less than, lesser than, equal to, less than or equal to. So again, we need to prioritize. So anyway, relationship can be established through these symbols, we can understand. And we need to identify, we need to prioritize the symbol here, which symbol will be concluded in this. So in this, among these three symbols, we already know that we need to give the priority to this lesser than symbol. It is obvious. Then what could be the relation from this? Obviously, we can write the relation between R and C as R less than C. So now that from a statement we concluded, we inferred something that R is relation between R and C as R less than C, which is matching our conclusion given. So this is also true. So both conclusions given are true here. So what will be the appropriate option here? The appropriate option is E. That is when both the conclusions 1 and 2 follow. So this is how we solve this anyway, probably simpler one. And because it has become simple, because all the two statements are given, we could easily merge them. So we will solve such more and more problems in our short videos. So do watch our other short videos also. So this is about this problem. So friends, that was a short video. As a part of our short videos we are doing for your complete preparation, do subscribe to our channel and find other videos also, so that you will be getting the notifications. Please press the bell icon and get the notifications. So I hope you like this video. Do like and share this with your friends, so that it will be helpful for them also. And don't forget to comment, and suggestions if any are very much welcome. Thank you so much for watching this video.